And in the daylight, we can hitchhike to Maine.
Hey class, today we're going to measure the speed of light using marshmallows. And how we're going to do that is we're going to use a microwave. And how a microwave works is it sends waves of light through the food and it gets cooked at the crests and the troughs of that wave. And we already figured out the speed of our, or the frequency of our wavelength, which is 2450 megahertz. And we're going to find out what the wavelength is, and we're hopefully, when we multiply them using the formula C equals frequency times wavelength, we can figure out the speed of light. Okay, so what you're going to make sure is you have your marshmallows evenly on the plate and distributed across the whole entire surface of the plate. And what we're going to do is take out the rotating plate to make sure that it doesn't cook evenly and we can distinctly see where it melts, which is going to be the points of the crest and the trough. So we're going to put it in here for a minute. So the various spots we see where it's melted is where we would find the crests or the troughs of the wavelength sent by the microwave. So as I said before, the reason we didn't rotate is because we don't want to cook it evenly. We want to make sure there's these distinct melting points. So I'm just going to pick a random two. I'll say this one and this one, and I'm going to measure the distance between them. Okay, so as we can see, that's roughly 6 centimeters, so that's 0.06 meters in SI units. So after converting our centimeters to meters, we got 0.06 meters because we have to make sure they're in SI units. And our formula is length equals 1/2 wavelength, so 0.06 times 2 equals our wavelength. So we get our wavelength of 0.12 meters. And from what we said before, our frequency is 2450 megahertz, and mega is times 10 to the 6, so it's 2450 times 10 to the 6 hertz. Now Lessy will do the calculations on the calculator and tell me what that number is. Okay, so you guys have to trust me, that's the right amount of zeros. It's 2.94 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. So using our calculations, we found out that our speed of light was 2.94 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. So we're going to find out percent error now. So the formula for percent error is the absolute value of actual minus theoretical over theoretical times 100. So in our case, our theoretical is 2.99 times 10 to the 8 meters per second, which is the speed of light. And our actual is 2.94 times 10 to the 8, which is what we got, over the theoretical, which is 2.99 times 10 to the 8th. And what we got was 1.67% error. So basically, we got, it was a really good experiment. If I was going to write a conclusion, I'd say it was a success. And thank you for watching.
Give me the green light. Give me just one night.
Hey class.
I'm ready to go right now. I'm ready to go right now.
Okay, I'm gonna put it in for 1 minute.
I'm checking your smile, working your back like it's going out of style. Shake just a little bit faster, shake just a little.